Next article, Washington's blog. FDA refuses to test fish for radioactivity. Government pretends radioactive fish is safe. And I said, the ostrich defense of hiding your head in the sand seems still the favored reaction. Next article, Joseph Mangano of the Radiation Public Health Project on effects of low-level radiation. As the corporate media continues to claim that low levels of radiation are safe, many researchers and experts, including Dr. Chris Buzzley, believe they are dangerous, and they are. So I said, good to hear backing for my video, Big Lie of Low-Level Radiation. Yet no one talks about the squared danger. You won't hear this on any mainstream news. Nuclear Facts, a very clued in professional who will not be bought or intimidated into silence. Dr. Helen Caldicott, true to style, tells it as it is. As she sees it, you won't usually hear the truth, so listen up. And she talks about the nuclear fallout from Japan and what it's going to do to Canada. And she's very pessimistic. She thinks it's too late to do anything about it. We're all going to die. So I said, duck and cover. So Helen Caldicott calls Fukushima the greatest catastrophe in the history of mankind, too. Though she says there's nothing we can now do about it, and we're all dead. I say mass producing free marijuana can fight the cancers she knows we can expect. This is Rents and Yoshi Shimatsu, where he says Fukushima is worse and virtually hopeless. So Yoshi Shimatsu, former editor of the Weekly Japan Times, discusses the dire situation of Fukushima and concludes by calling for the dismemberment of the globalist elite planners. What, the Rothschild boys who make everybody do everything mediocre, always going to the lowest bidder? You can't control them. They have all the money and all the guns. We cannot allow these globalist people to be running the world anymore. I mean, look at what they're doing. I know. The Rothschilds really screwed up. The world mediocrity, all due to one family. Isn't that sick? Millions and millions of deaths due to one family? So I answered, at 3:09, it seems that Canada is going to bear the brunt of the catastrophe that's going to be with us for a century. There is the plume, and you can see that it is aimed right at Canada's west coast, just a little to the north of California. And though Californians are complaining about 180 times the radioactivity, and now people in France and Europe are complaining about the radioactivity, get out of the radioactive rain and stop drinking milk. In Canada, we turned off our fallout detectors, let our kids go outside and play in the radioactivity and drink all the milk they want. I said, I feel like crying about all my fellow Canadians who got a good, unhealthy dose of radioactive fallout last week without taking my warning seriously. Only 50 or 60 people have gone to see my latest videos, so who the heck is interested in listening to an engineer who's telling them to get out of the radioactive rain? So they deserve to die, though, don't they? I told you they were warning Californians to get out of the rain and avoid the radioactive milk, and now this video shows them warning Europeans to get out of the rain and avoid the milk. But my friends in between, who took the brunt of the first plume on its first time around, weren't told by a government of lawyers who lied to them that there was nothing to worry about. We could sue Japan, while turning off their fallout detectors for plausible deniability they knew. Most of my friends and allies did and said nothing. Didn't tell their families to duck and cover. I'm going to have to attend their kids' funerals and look them in the eye and say, why didn't you shout duck and cover too, when the Californians did and before the Europeans did. Think about all my friends and allies who didn't pass along the duck and cover message. Anyway, we took the first wave as it travels around the world with irresponsible leadership, negligent leadership. Blame Harper for not telling you to get out of the radioactive rain before you got X'd. You donkeys who did nothing when all you had to do was communicate. Not even get out of a chair. Call talk shows, complain about the fallout detectors being turned off. Am I the only one who wants them turned back on? Another comment. When you hear this video and see Caldicott's, it's too big to be fixed attitude, How can you not be terrified? It's a job for a lawyer, or an economist, or an engineer for our salvation. You people should be screaming in terror rather than just sitting there getting baked in the sun or scalded in the rain. Next comment. And we had the monstrous bad luck to have all this rain, even today, whole week of it. Rather than most passing overhead, much more than would have did come down. Lots more contamination by bad luck. At 3:09 of this video, it shows that Canada is worse off than the United States on the path of the first worst swirl around the planet. If you didn't take your baking soda, didn't stay indoors and out of the rain, didn't recycle your urine, you can sue the government for not warning you so your kids can collect. Next comment. Anyway, how long would it take to wake up millions of Canadians on Facebook to the danger within the next 2 weeks? If people with the brains to understand our dire predicament start stating their terror to everyone they meet, like I've been doing. I mean, I'm terrified. I've been out into the weather 5 minutes in the last 2 weeks. Me into the car, car inside. I haven't gone outside at all otherwise. And the only way to improve the odds of surviving is to vote for the engineer's dream team of election candidates who will let me reprogram the Bank of Canada's computer to work like PayPal, where you pledge Visa or time, and you can pay back with cash or time, with interest-free loans for jobs to mass-produce marijuana for free to the victims of nuclear contamination. Next comment. How long does it take for the dream team to go viral enough to wake up Canadians to what danger we face and what we must now do to survive the disaster? I mean, do Harper and Ignatieff really want to rule a nation with massive numbers dying and no money for health care? Anyone else wanting to lead this nuclear disaster on us but that losingest candidate in the world? That's the kind of fun they're going to preside over. Who wants to be leading while everyone is dying? That the only question is whether any another could have coped better. Har har. Anyway, I've had a long and full life and don't mind going early. Of course, not without maximum resistance. But feel bad for the kids who get cut down more than the adults and lose a lot more. Sure, we're not going to die in the next year or two. We've all lost 5 or 10 or 15 years off our average. Okay, look at it that way. Your kids used to be able to expect to live to 75. Now, on average, they're only going to make it to 60 because you let them go out and play in the rain. Next article, nuclear weather worsens. Every day the news gets worse. Today, radiation levels are just heading up across the board and across continents. Sunday morning, the news was so bad, I didn't know what to do or write, says this guy. I could try screaming, but I'm not the type. Or crying. Well, that comes almost too easily. Avoiding exposure and radiation-induced diseases might come down to, I'm terribly sorry, running for our lives. So he already said this. And I said, boy, did he say how I feel and why I'm running for Prime Minister of Canada to warn people to get out of the radioactive rain. Radioactive Fukushima plutonium and strontium bombarding U.S. West Coast since March 18th. And I said, just to the north, we Canucks are tough. You don't see us worrying about the radioactive fallout. We solved the problem by turning off our fallout detectors and letting our kids go out and play in the radioactive rain. Canucks are tough enough to take a little radiation, and our kids too. So Stuart Davies said the huge hydrogen explosion at Unit 3 must have occurred in the reactor itself, and that the entire top of the reactor containment vessel was obliterated, ejecting the contents of the core as well as the spent fuel pool into the atmosphere. This means, obviously, that the significant quantities of plutonium were released. I mean, the iodine radioactive, that's got a half-life of 8 days, so that half of it's left in 8 days, a quarter of it in 16 days, an eighth of it in 24 days, a 16th of it in 32 days. That goes down pretty fast, but plutonium's got a half-life of half a million years, so it's going to stick around all our lives. This means, obviously, that it's been blown up and that the release of radiation from Unit 3 alone must be many times higher than has been admitted for the entire complex. Chernobyl pales in comparison. Chernobyl pales in comparison with its million dead. It is apparent that TEPCO, the NRC, the Japanese American government officials, amongst others, are participating in a cover-up of the extent and severity of the disaster. This almost certainly applies to the blandly misleading assurances about the harmlessness of the fallout on U.S. soil. The whistle must be blown loud and clear. Dr. Stephen Wing and Arne Gundersen discuss global radiation exposure and consequences. Gundersen, if we have a lot of rain out that drops a lot of radiation on us, and I said, just to the north of that radioactive fallout hitting U.S. West Coast, we Canucks are tough. We had rain out all week, and you don't see us worrying about the radioactive fallout. We sent our kids to play out in the rain. Japan nuclear secrets, past reactor damage hidden from the government. So, what other result can there be from building everything with the lowest bidder? We're so busy paying interest to the world owners, there isn't enough to build things right. Rothschild mediocrity everywhere, and now it's obviously costing lives. Japan nuclear iodine radiation in Idaho rain, 14,000% above EPA limit. And I said, bunch of chicken Yankees who are worried about a little radio wave. In Canada, we turned off our fallout detectors. Radiation expert. Strontium 90 and uranium and particulates will be building up in the USA and Europe. And I said, just to the north, we're not scared. We're Canadians. We're smart. Japan tsunami, Fukushima nuclear disaster. Two long videos by Lurin Moret. And she's a whistleblower on nuclear power. And she explains how the excess deaths occurred downwind of the nuclear reactors and then what kind of catastrophe is going on right now. At the 3940 mark, Seattle and California really got pummeled by the fallout, she said. And I said, just to the north of all that radioactivity, Canucks are tough. We turned off our fallout detectors. Japan now admits Fukushima at 154 trillion becquerels per day, and the West Coast radiation forecast. So, radiation is cumulative and much more dangerous when ingested than when you're just exposed to it. And I said, and they blame it on a calculation error that it's really 154 trillion and not much lower. I went, a calculation error caused the authorities to downplay the threat and not warn people to get out of the radioactive rain? A calculation error that's going to cost years off the average lifespan of everyone. A calculation error, sure. You too for low-level radiation. The damage it does isn't linear, it's squared. So, that's what we're facing. And we Canucks, well, let's call us, we're Harper's heroes. We weren't scared of the radiation. Harper said, let's just turn off those fallout detectors and send our kids outside to play in the radioactive radiation, radioactive rain, and give them some radioactive milk to drink. Thank you, Stephen Harper, Prime Minister of the country, for letting them turn off our fallout detectors and not causing us to panic and stay indoors. So, after that depressing episode of what's happened to us and how we've been contaminated by the radiation, most of us, by the irresponsible and negligent actions of the lawyers and economists in government. Now's the time to go out there and vote for another lawyer or an economist to save you. Or you can vote for my dream team. JohnTurmel.com/dreamteam.htm, where you can find a list of candidates, small party candidates, and independents, I recommend you vote for. And if they should get in, then you get me to legalize marijuana so that we mass produce it to kill all the cancers and reprogram the Bank of Canada's computer to operate interest-free, give you interest-free loans so we maximize jobs and everybody gets back to work, decommissioning nuclear, cleaning up, and saving ourselves. Otherwise, don't vote for the engineer's dream team. Vote for one of the lawyers or the economists. You deserve to die.